Welcome to another Power BI tutorial. Today, we will learn to analyze and present credit sales data. Specifically, credit sales having doubtful or bad debts. We have a data set of credit sales transactions of more than 14,000 transactions. Data consists of transaction ID, date, amount of sales, days past, and classification. In the second sheet, we have the definition of debt classification. And in the third sheet, we have the names of stores where the transaction took place, identified by transaction ID. First, import the Excel file using the Get Data feature. In the Navigator window, select all the tables and press Load. Wait for the data to load. Most of the time, data is correctly loaded. However, sometimes there are problems. Here, two tables were not loaded properly. To correct the tables, go to the Query Editor. Here, click on the Use First Row as Header button. Do the same in the other table. The third table has correct headings, so leave it. Click on the Close and Apply button. Now all fields have correct names. Go to the model view to connect the tables. In our case, the relationships have been made automatically by Power BI. If the relationships are not made, create a relationship between transactions and stores table based on transaction ID. Now, go to the table view. Open the transactions table. In the table view, select the classification column and click on the New Data Group button in Data Groups menu button. In the Groups window, select all doubtful debt stages and click on the Group button. Change the title of the group to Doubtful and press OK. Now we have another classifications column, where we have only three classifications instead of five. This is how you group data in table view. Create a new column to calculate late charges. There are no late charges in case of regular debt. Therefore, using the if formula, we will assign zero charges against all regular debts. However, if the debt is not regular, then a certain amount is charged, based on the amount of credit sales and the number of days past. Enter the formula here. You can also enter 1/1000 or 0.0001 here. Multiply this by number of days past. Press Enter after the formula has been completed. As you can see, there is zero charge against regular credit. However, let's scroll down. And here you can see that different amounts have been charged against doubtful and bad debts. Create another column to calculate total amount due. Total amount equals the amount of credit sales plus any late fee charged by the system. Now, before creating any visualizations, format the amounts in properly. We will use the comma-separated numbers, without any decimal points. Now, go to the report view. Hide the filters for now. Add a slicer to your report. From the transaction date, add quarter field to the slicer. Place the slicer at the top right corner and change it to a drop-down list. Add visual borders to the slicer. Add a text box visual to your dashboard and place it at the top left corner. Enter an appropriate title for your report. Make it prominent by increasing its font size. Turn on its visual borders from Format pane. Set the font to bold as well. Add a table visual to your dashboard. Add the classification field to the columns area. Add the total field to the columns area as well. Late charges should also be added. And finally, let's add the credit sales field as well. Turn on the visual border for table visual. Make a copy of the table visual and place it below the existing visual. Now, replace the classification group field with the classification field. As you can observe, both visuals apply filters to the other visual. Click on one of them. From the Format tab, click on the Edit Interactions button. Now disable interactions for both visuals from each other. Now, they will not apply filters to each other. Make a duplicate of one of the visuals and place it at the bottom right corner. Remove the total and classification fields. Add the transaction date and change the visual to a line and column chart. Remove the day and quarter fields. Move the late charges field to line y-axis. If dates do not work properly, remove and add again. Add the classification field to the filters. Hiding the doubtful and regular debt. Now, we can view the bad debts during the period. Let's rename the title as Bad Debts. Add a column chart to your dashboard. From the Stores table, add the Store field to the X-axis of column chart. And credit sales to the y-axis. Turn on the visual borders. Make a copy of this chart, and place it next to the existing chart. Change it to 100% stacked column chart. Add a scatter chart visual. Add the credit sales to x-axis, and the late charges, to y-axis, of the scatter chart. Change both fields, to don't summarize. Turn on the visual borders. You can also add classification field, to the legend area of the scatter chart. Adjust the legend to an appropriate place, to make it readable. Adjust the scatter chart for better appearance. Finally, we will add a histogram, which we will import from a file. You can get one online. Add it to your dashboard. Add the credit sales field to both values, and frequency, of the histogram visual. Change the bin size to 5, and add visual borders, to your histogram. Your dashboard is now complete. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.